So there's a great apocalypse. They call it the cellular rebellion, the moment at which every cell rebels every other cell. But before this happens, there is a group of artists, and they assemble, and they decide that for once in their lives, they are going to inhabit a position of power. And so they build two machines. The first machine enables one to relive every experience they have ever had in their entire life in vivid detail, incredibly vivid detail, more vivid than the experience itself, but they can't form new memories. The second machine enables one to act out their deepest desires, their greatest fantasies, anything they want at any moment in time can be, it will be, but they can't remember anything. And it comes to pass that the entire population, all of humanity, has chosen one of these two machines. And for a while, it's beautiful. There is birth and there is death, and there is no conflict in between. However, something goes terribly wrong. It all falls apart. But it's okay. It's okay because it's hilarious. And it's okay because it's beautiful. Because whether it's before the apocalypse, or after the apocalypse, or anywhere in between, there is still one song. And this is the last song that you will hear, and it will play for all eternity.
This is that song.
Thank you.
the end of the set, it's quite possible that I will surpass this glass of water. So I slowly inch forward, but we'll see if that actually happens. Are you gonna put, oh, how do we measure it? How do we measure change now? I'll try and play very quickly.
But how can you ever measure change without knowing whether you affected the measurement yourself?
This next song is called The Apocalypse is Witnessed by a Slice of American Cheese.
Thank you.
Okay. That's precarious.
You got so much closer. It's not my fault.
That moved this way a lot.
Well, you moved this way.
This next song is about having fun. Who likes to have fun? Yeah, fun. This is specifically about having fun on an amusement park ride. Does anyone know what the Gravitron is? Oh yeah, she knows. Do you want to tell these fine people what the Gravitron is, who don't know what the Gravitron is?
Well, you just go round and round, and the lights go down, and some other lights go up, and the bottom drops, and you're against the wall.
Yeah.
And then you throw up.
And then you throw up.
Depending on how many
on yourself.
That's the next person to your right that you throw up on, right? Just spinning.
Yeah. Okay, so when I was 15 years old, I met a group of kids, and they were older than me, and they had a car, and they said, "Hey, do you want to go with us to the Maryland State Fair?" And I said, "Yeah, that sounds like a lot of fun." And so I got in their car, and they had a lot of peppermint schnapps and beer. And I had on this brand new leather jacket that I bought at the thrift store that I was super excited about. And I was like, okay, this is really awesome. This is everything's, yeah. And so I got really drunk for the first time. And then, so we're drinking in the car. We get out of the car. We are walking around the fair. And they're like, hey, let's go on the Gravitron. And so I remember getting on the Gravitron, but I don't remember getting off the Gravitron. Which is to say that you never get off the Gravitron, because when the bottom drops out, it doesn't come back. So that's what this song is about. It's about having fun.
Thank you.
it's Cohen on drums. This next song is called West Virginia. That's the end of that.
Thank you. Thank you.
For God allowed geometry, for God allowed geometry, for God allowed geometry, for God allowed geometry, for God allowed geometry.
Okay.
Thanks so much.